A little over 66%.
Okay. All right. So you think we'll be hitting 100% by the end of the day?
I lost the feed.
Do you think we'll be hitting 100% by the end of the day?
That's very doubtful. That's very, very doubtful. I'm going by our experience in 2010. We were able to get 80% within the first 12 hours after the closing of elections. So by 7 p.m. the next day in 2010, 7 a.m. rather, we already had roughly 80%. But after that, it was a crawl. We took around 1.5 to 2 weeks to reach 92%. And once it reached 92%, it never went above that. So there was 8% that we never saw in 2010.
Now, Anna, I did cover the 2010 elections. It seems to me, unless I'm wrong, that the count is much faster this elections.
I'm just basing it on our data because I was reviewing our data this morning. As of this time, we were already able to get roughly 80% of the transmissions versus the 66% we have now. So a slight, not naman tendentially different, no? So okay naman.
Anna, this is David. Just a question for you. We had
COMELEC chairman Sixto Brillantes earlier in the program, and he sticks by the figure of just over 200 PCOS machines that were malfunctioning yesterday.
250 na daw.
Or 250, they've added 50 more. But you go with anecdotal evidence, people calling in, talking to you about their personal experiences, it seems like much more. What does the PPCRV have in terms of numbers of PCOS machines that were down yesterday?
What we did was, we will go with the COMELEC number in terms of the PCOS machines because they have the quantitative analysis of that. What we did is, last night, we compared the data that we got from our call center versus the 2010 call center data, and it does seem that there is a smaller amount of PCOS malfunctions this year versus 2010. And I think we should also commend COMELEC because many of the issues that were seen early in the morning, and I guess you can anticipate early morning technical issues because they're machines after all, many of them were resolved between 10:30 or 11 in the morning. So the resolution was quite quick, especially in Northern Luzon, areas of Batangas, Novaliches. We were quite pleased with the speed of resolution of the PCOS machine issues there.
Right, let's go back to the PPCRV count. I mean, after yesterday's snafu, if you can call it that, just how confident are you now with the figures we're seeing? I mean, because anything can happen. I mean, if it happened yesterday, people are thinking this could be the same problem again without us knowing.
Okay, well, actually, just to make it clear for everybody, the data from the server, the transparency server, which is the source data of the PPCRV server, there was nothing wrong with the data. The data was good, it was reliable, we are confident about the data. The problem was there was a formatting error in terms of the way it was sent to us. Smartmatic is the one who formats the data in the server, transparency server, that is sent to the different workstations. Like the people with the groups with workstations are PPCRV, KBP, LP, UNA, ABS-CBN, GMA,
PV5,
Solar,
Rappler,
and NAMFREL. But NAMFREL was not there last night.
You're confident
night, no?
that
there was a
has
slight
resolved.
Script error. There was a slight script error by Smartmatic, which Smartmatic identified right away and fixed within 20 minutes. So the resolution was very quick. There was just a little bit of a double count, which they immediately removed, and they were able to resolve that in like 15 minutes. So I'd like to thank Marlon Garcia of Smartmatic, actually, for identifying the problem very quickly and for resolving it very quickly. We're confident that that won't happen anymore because we've done several passes. Even before starting broadcast, we did several passes in the transparency server room to make sure that the data was clean. So we're very confident that that won't be happening anymore. The script was properly fixed.
All right, I asked that question, Anna, because predictably you'll have candidates who are trailing in the count who would say that we can't trust these figures that we're showing on TV. But you're telling us that you're extremely confident at this point that the numbers are now accurate.
Yes, we are. As I said, it was not a matter of wrong data. Mm-hmm. It was a matter of the formatting wherein some of the data was double counted.
That's correct.
They immediately fixed the script, and what they did was to remove the double count. Because what was happening actually, David, was like the data of the transmissions come in batches. Mm-hmm. What happened was that the transmission of, let's say, the first batch was added in total to the transmission of the second batch, when what you should really do is only add the increment, only the changes. That was immediately fixed. It was a very simple script error. That's why I think Smartmatic and Marlon Garcia was able to identify it immediately and find resolution as well. So yes, we are very confident of the data.
All right,
now.
That's all we wanted to hear. Anna Davila Singson from the PPCRV, thank you so much for making that clear to us.
All right, back in the studio, UP Assistant Professor Dr. Nicole.